I'll be sprinkling sex appeal all over shop till seven. Okay, I won't. Whatever. You're not here for that. Right, let's get some news. Radio 2 on the BBC Sounds app on your smart speaker and on 88 to 91 FM.
We're the BBC News at 6 o'clock. This is Jason Kay. The biggest rail strike in decades is going ahead at midnight after last-ditch talks failed to resolve a bitter dispute about pay, jobs and conditions. Tens of thousands of RMT union members employed by Network Rail and 13 train operators are to take part in the action. London Underground workers will also walk out tomorrow. The Transport Secretary Grant Shapps has insisted he shouldn't interfere in talks on modernisation between rail unions and managers. But Labour's Shadow Transport Secretary Louise Haig accused him of dereliction of duty.
The entire country is about to be ground to a halt, but instead of intervening to try and stop it, the Secretary of State is washing his hands of any responsibility. On the eve of the biggest rail dispute in a generation taking place on his watch, he has still not lifted a finger to resolve it.
Oldham Council and Greater Manchester Police have apologised after an independent report concluded they'd failed to protect some children from grooming and sexual exploitation in the town between 2011 and 2014. The review says that in one case, police missed opportunities to help a 12-year-old girl who was raped and seemed more concerned about covering up their failures. A former police officer in Manchester Police, Maggie Oliver, who now runs a charity helping victims of sexual abuse, says she fears the institutions haven't changed enough.
I don't think abuse is still ongoing in the Manchester area. I know from my work today in the foundation, you know, in 6 months, 33 serious failures have been referred to GMP by the foundation. They will be the tip of the iceberg. These failures are still happening today.
An exam board in England has said it's disappointed that an A-level chemistry paper was leaked online ahead of an exam today. AQA said it would make sure that no one gained unfair advantage and it would monitor for students whose performance in the exam was suspicious. Around 30 flights from Heathrow Airport have been cancelled because of technical problems with its baggage system. The airport asked airlines to cut 10% of their flights today after pictures emerged of a mountain of suitcases over the weekend. The travel editor for the Independent website, Simon Calder, says the situation is now improving.
They've taken the amazing baggage mountain down from Terminal 2. This was over the weekend. People had checked in those bags, but they hadn't been able to go into the baggage system because that had broken. Instead, they were taken out and kind of piled up as a kind of pop-up artwork. And they finally got those moved. Some of them, I understand, are being put in trucks and sent over to continental Europe to be reunited with their owners.
A grand piano owned by George Michael is to be auctioned in support of the music therapy charity Nordoff Robbins. The sale is to be held in London on July the 1st. And the weather. There'll be some rain overnight in Scotland and Northern Ireland, while England and Wales will be largely dry. That's the BBC News at 3 minutes past six.
Jason, thank you very much.
When there's someone by your side to sing,
life's a happy song. When there's someone by your side to sing,
we are by your side till 7 o'clock. Then Jo will be rocking up with her shiny happy playlist. Tonight's NPD.
Hi, I'm Melanie from Merseyside. I'm being a maverick having a Monday roast dinner.
Ooh, oh, yes, Melanie. All round to Melanie's. Come on. Tomorrow on the Zoe Ball Breakfast Show, the one, the only, Sir Lenny Henry joins Zoe to chat about his new programme, Lenny Henry's Caribbean Britain. Love that man.
walks down the street. He says, why am I soft in the middle now? Why am I soft in the middle? The rest of my